Teams behind the lines in 3, 2, 1, go!
And we begin a match between two teams in the top three. The two alliances, sums of their rankings are almost identical. This promises to be an exciting, close match as during the tournament, it is tied. Oh no, 16-12 in favor of the Blue Alliance. An extra cargo went in at the last second. Quicksilver scores a shower of high hub goals, and the Red Alliance takes the lead. There's hard battling between 47-65 and 72-45 on the far end of the field from me, while more cargo pours in for the Red Alliance. The Red Alliance is on a rally as the score expands right now to 22-18. At the same time, looks like that 22-51 has a red cargo in and discards it. 54-30, looking for position. Meanwhile, where's Quicksilver? And there's a goal, another goal for the Blue Alliance in the high hub. The score is nearly tied between these two closely matched teams. Quicksilver grabs a cargo and tries to line up to score, but being defended tenaciously by 47-65. Nevertheless, Quicksilver scores two high goals, and the lead for the Red Alliance is 36-30. Quicksilver scores another high hub goal, and extends the lead, approaching the 10-point lead, but there, 25-51, takes two beautiful shots, but they both balance out. The frustration must be magnificent. There's a 10-point lead for the Red Alliance, with another ball rolling out to make it 42-30, and two more Red Alliance cargo go in, while 25-51 climbs to the high rung. They're working on trying to do a traversal as the horn sounds, and two more high goals go in, making it so that the Red Alliance has achieved the ranking point associated with scoring cargo. Will they go on to any kind of hanging effort? There's something going on down here close by, don't quite know what. Meanwhile, another couple of cargo go shooting in for the Red Alliance. And there is some climbing. 62-38 pulls off a mid-level climb, and we'll see what the final score is. At 64-51, three ranking points for the Red Alliance, one ranking point for the Blue Alliance.